My colleague and consulting editor Rajdeep Sardesai is now joining us live from Kolkata on this, of course, very important and high-octane battle. Rajdeep, namaskar, good morning to you. Mamata Banerjee leading from Bhavanipur, but can she namaskar. Be absolutely confident given the surprise Nandigram sprung?
Well, I think... Pallavi, first of all, good morning, namaskar. We are here in North Kolkata in a puja pandal, or soon to be a full-scale puja pandal, the last big weekend before the puja celebrations really start. Can Mamata Banerjee celebrate a little early? Perhaps, because at the end of the day, very difficult to defeat a sitting chief minister in a bipoll. I was trying to go through the history to see if any sitting chief minister had been defeated in a bipoll of this nature in the first year of his or her power, and I couldn't find an instance. So there's a huge advantage, obviously, to a sitting chief minister. Having said that, as was suggested by the BJP guest, Dr. Prasoon, that Bhavanipur in the Lok Sabha, the Trinamool actually trailed to the BJP in that particular segment. So it's not as if, you know, it's a done deal and this has been always a bastion of the Trinamool. But you would expect Mamata Banerjee to win. I think it's more about the margin that she wins by, because I think that will give her a sense of confidence after the defeat of Nandigram. My colleague Indrajit is with us. Also, Shikha Mukherjee, senior journalist who's tracked Bengal for years. And Riju Datta joins us as of the TMC. Of course, we also have Dr. Prasoon of the BJP. But Indrajit, you know, the question of this election going down to the wire, the amount of effort that the BJP has put in, for example, they had about half a dozen union ministers who've come in, 40% non-Bengali population, so bringing in the likes of Hardeep Puri, Smriti Irani. Clearly, the BJP wants to give it a fight. Is there a sense that it's about the margin in the end of the day that Mamata Banerjee wins by? If she squeaks home again, there will be question marks. If she wins big, then she has an element of comfort. Is it now about the margins, basically, or is there a real chance of a possible upset?
Well, you know, as far as the BJP is concerned, initially they were finding it difficult to, you know, pit a candidate against Mamata Banerjee. And that was very evident from what the previous state BJP chief Dilip Ghosh had said. He was candid about it. Finally, a BJP, of course, zeroed in on Priyanka Tibrewal, fresh from her success at the Calcutta High Court case on post-poll violence. In fact, she has written a letter to the Chief Justice of the Calcutta High Court saying that, you know, there should be some preemptive steps taken so that there is no post-poll violence today once the results are out. Mm-hmm. So clearly the BJP found Priyanka Tibrewal as the best candidate. The BJP lost this seat just a few months back in the assembly elections. They fought it well. For the BJP, what they think, of course, is that they should be able to give a tough fight to Mamata Banerjee. As you said, it's heavily stacked against the BJP, against the opposition party here, because we haven't seen, the record doesn't suggest that a sitting chief minister losing a bipoll.
Is this about, Shikha, about at the end of the day, Mamata Banerjee at least having the security that she is an elected chief minister? Because for the last few months, the BJP has been able to target her, saying, look, you may be the chief minister with this big victory, but you lost Nandigram. So is Bhavanipur in that sense a consolation, or does that provide her a sense of comfort?
I think it provides her with the kind of legitimacy that is absolutely expected of a chief minister with national political ambitions more than anything else. And I think
she has those national ambitions. You see, do you see, for example, in the last month, the manner in which Trinamool is trying to spread into Tripura, Goa, we are told possibly Meghalaya. Is that, therefore, Bhavanipur important for her to at least know that now she's secure in Bengal, let's move beyond Bengal?
Absolutely. And that is why the credibility and the legitimacy of this election is critical for her. Because by winning with a convincing margin, she therefore establishes her presence even more solidly, if I may put it that way. And really, when she's taking the fight out of West Bengal, she needs that solid credibility to take on the BJP, because that's what she's trying to do.
Interesting the way you're putting it. Riju Datta, you know, your candidate, Mr. Chattopadhyay, won the election by what? About
29,000
votes in May this year. So Mamata Banerjee, presumably you would want her to win by double. The fact is, though, the voter turnout was low, just about 53% voter turnout. So clearly, it's not for you only about winning. You need to win big, because otherwise the BJP is going to say, this is a chief minister who is struggling to establish her supremacy in her own constituency, a constituency that she won in 2016.
First of all, I want to touch upon some topics that Mr. Prasoon said and my good friend Indro also said here. Priyanka Tibrewal, I will remind the viewers that Priyanka Tibrewal contested an election in May from against Shonno Komal Shah from the Intelli constituency, and she lost by around 59,000 votes. Mm-hmm. So it was not about finding the best candidate. It was basically BJP finding a patsy to stand in front of the persona of Mamata Banerjee. Let's clear that first. Now, secondly, if you see Bhavanipur, this is the same constituency that Mamata Banerjee won MP elections for 6 times. Now, in this election, again coming back to that.
But no, let's be clear, Riju Datta, she's entering this election as a chief minister who lost, right? At the end of the day, the BJP has had a huge propaganda weapon against the chief minister that you are a non-elected chief minister.
Can I quickly come in here?
Yes.
I don't know how she lost, because the matter is in court, and the court wouldn't have accepted the matter if it would have clearly lost.
You still believe she won on the ground?
I still believe that the CCTVs were off and there are EVM machines which are still not counted, and the court will decide on that. I don't think Mamata Banerjee lost the election of Nandigram.
Dr. Prasoon, you want to respond to that? Because, you know, the Trinamool Congress has taken the election to court, but the fact is that Bhavanipur, does it become for you simply about the margin, ensuring that Mamata Banerjee doesn't win big? Is that what this election for the BJP is about?
Actually, I think Bhavanipur election, the way we fought, the way we struggled, the way we tried to assert ourselves is indicative of the collective resentment of the people of West Bengal against the culture of violence unleashed by the Trinamool, especially the post-poll violence. This was one. That's why Priyanka Tibrewal was selected. This is one. Number two, as we look at the history of elections, in 2011, Honorable Chief Minister got around 77% of votes of Bhavanipur. And in 2016, that got reduced to 47%. And after that, subsequently, in several elections, you know, the Bhavanipur, showed, and as well as her ward, you know, Trinamool trailed. So Bhavanipur has always been showing a kind of resentment against the Chief Minister every now and then. Now, this particular election, the result is to some extent irrelevant, simply because we did not feel that we are going to get defeated. We wanted ourselves to be heard by the whole country. We wanted ourselves to be asserted. And in the process, so far as this election, the petition that has been filed by Honorable Chief Minister is concerned, we have our more than 12 MLAs, or even more than that, I don't remember the names. They have also filed different petitions in various courts. Challenging the decisions, challenging the election results.
So no, it's,
it does not mean much.
It's interesting.
Yeah.
It's, it's interesting that you're saying that this... you're trying to send... Yeah, it's interesting that you're saying that this is not just about who wins or loses, but you're also trying to suggest that you want to make Bhavanipur representative of what you believe is the culture of violence and intimidation of the Trinamool. Yes, Ms. Mukherjee wanted to respond.
Yeah, just a couple of facts. Which is that in this election, in the 2021 election in May, the Trinamool candidate won the seat with a 58% vote share.
Mm-hmm.
58% vote share, as all of us know, is a significant vote share. It's above 50, and above 50 in elections is considered very significant. Mamata Banerjee's vote share in the previous election was 48%. So the Trinamool has actually gained 10% between 2016 and 2020.
No, I often wondered why Mamata Banerjee didn't choose Bhavanipur as her constituency, because there was this whole belief that Prashant Kishore, who was advising her, believed that, you know, let's take the battle into the enemy camp, let's take on Shuvendu Adhikari, your one-time lieutenant, and send out a message that I'm not scared of anyone. In hindsight, was that a mistake in your view?
No, I don't think so. I think it was politically, strategically necessary.
It was.
It was, because Shubhendu Adhikari's exit and the intensity of the campaign that the BJP launched against Mamata Banerjee, that needed a counter. And that needed for the party to come together against as a coherent working machine.
Interesting. Yeah, you believe that that was, did they get that wrong? Were they?
I don't think they got it wrong. It was a carefully construed strategic move because, you know, factually, and it's sub judice right now, but the fact is the Election Commission has declared Shubhendu Adhikari the winner in Nandigram. But Mamata Banerjee may have lost the battle in Nandigram, but she has won 213 seats for the Trinamool Congress. She was the candidate in all those seats. She was the star campaigner.
She could have contested both Babanipur and Nandigram.
But the strategy on part of the Trinamool Congress, which seemed to have worked, is that she was able to contain Shubhendu Adhikari, the novelty factor of Shubhendu Adhikari, jumping to the BJP and whatever organization that was being touted as his own in districts like Midnapur East and West, in other parts of, you know, Rar Bengal. There, the Trinamool Congress has not just recovered, but they have gained as well. So that seems to be the strategy that has worked for Trinamool Congress. So in hindsight, we can surely say that the strategy has worked.
Interesting the way, because, you know, generally you have chief ministers or prospective chief ministers contesting in more than one seat.
Yeah.
If you feel an element of doubt, but Suryangani Roy is outside the house of Mamata Banerjee in Kalighat, office come residence, as she now calls it there. Suryangani, is there a sense of anticipation? Are we going to see early celebrations ahead of Durga Puja at Mamata Banerjee's house? Is that what they're preparing for? Or is this another day in the office, another Sunday for Mamata Banerjee?
Well, you know, when we started off, we thought that we will see a lot of people over here who, you know, will be bringing colors and banners and, you know, music with them, just like every time, you know, they prepare themselves just before the election results come out. But extremely shocking that we do not see any supporters over here. It's almost, you know, we are heading towards 10. The first round of the counting has, you know, it's summing up. Trinamool is, you know, is leading in these three seats. But there is no, you know, we can't see much of a celebration so far. Maybe, you know, somewhere the Trinamool Congress wants to show their confidence that they, it's a very regular day for them and they do not, you know, they are not taking the BJP that seriously that they'll, you know, bring up people and supporters to show that, you know, they are going to celebrate and this is just a normal day for them. That maybe that is the sense that they want to project. But we all know how important the seat of Bhavanipur is for the prestige of not only Trinamool Congress, but also for Mamata Banerjee personally as well, because if she loses this particular seat today, then a lot of complications will start, whether she can continue as the chief minister or not, what happens next and what happens to her national ambition, and BJP itself will get a very, very important topic to fight on, that they have defeated Mamata Banerjee not only once but twice, the second time being Bhavanipur, if that happens. But as of yet, to reply to your question, sir, I don't see much of the supporters or celebrations as of yet, but we are only hopeful that if and when Mamata Banerjee wins,
which is,
will be over here making sure that the COVID protocols are not violated as well. Back to you.
You know, in fact, those COVID protocols, in a way, it's good if there aren't, if the celebrations, if they are, if Mamata Banerjee does win, are kept muted, because I was just coming into this area of North Kolkata and we found the Khanna market on the way was like any other day, any other Sunday. It's the last big weekend before Durga Puja and there were no COVID protocols or no social distancing being observed anywhere. And politicians, in particular Riju Datta, have been perennial violators. I was looking at the Bhavanipur campaign as well. And, you know, y'all don't seem to want to maintain COVID protocols. You want all of us to mask up. You want all of us to socially distance. Why don't y'all do it during elections?
We always do it. But if you see, probably in Bengal, the politicians of Trinamool Congress probably pan India wise they mask up the most. But when the election campaigns are happening, Mr. Sardesai, and you are a very stalwart journalist who have been following elections throughout the length and breadth of this country, you will see, you know, the people who are involved with politics, and especially in Bengal, where people are very clued on to what is happening politically around, you know, emotions take over. And at that time, you know, all these protocols and everything, so sometimes it goes out of the window. And I think, you know, rather than blaming one particular party, we should look at it collectively.
The political culture, and I know it's difficult at election time when you're carried away by audiences and emotions, but the fact is, we the citizens are expected to observe COVID protocols at all times. But when it comes to elections, politicians seem to be in a league of their own. That's happened in Bhavanipur. We hope that whoever wins the election, indeed not just here, but in the three constituencies across Bengal and one in Odisha, observe the election COVID protocols. Let's take a break at this point. When we return, a little bit more. Mamata Banerjee at the moment is leading, we are told, by 2,800 votes. Remember, 21 rounds in all. But at the end of postal ballots and the first round, Mamata Banerjee establishing a 2,800 vote lead. Back in a moment on the battle for Bhavanipur.